April 1973. Tragedy and despair have struck Central Texas. A young college student named Maria Flores has seemingly vanished without a trace. She was last seen near the town of Newt more than 2 weeks ago, but with no physical evidence, the investigation has stalled. With few leads and even less hope, Maria's younger sister Ana Flores and a group of her closest friends set out to find their missing loved one. But any grief or sadness caused by Maria's disappearance would pale in comparison to the agony and despair they would soon discover. What awaited this group of youth?
Family now. It's up to you to secure the prop.
search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Marlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. The remains of an unidentified male have been discovered near Devil's River off Highway 163 in southwest Texas. A cedar canyon has been stumbled upon.
Thank you.
Search continues in Huerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The Sheriff's Department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search in nearby communities Marlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. A series of home invasions throughout Bell County have turned into a search for a known fugitive. Omar Pauly, native of Holland, Texas, was arrested in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The Sheriff's Department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. The man believed to be responsible for multiple stranglings in East Texas is finally in custody tonight. Authorities followed a tip that led them to a deserted motel outside Bryan, where they caught the man in the act of subduing 36-year-old Kelsey Keough. The man, whose name is being withheld, claimed he and Kelsey were participating in an agreed-upon way, and that he had no connections to the murders that have plagued the eastern part of the state since last June. The search continues in Muerto County.
I know you around here somewhere. Couldn't have gone much further. It's too foggy. Which way this is headed. They gotta be around here someplace. Thank you. That's it. Tastes good, don't it? Just get this over with. We didn't have much choice. We couldn't let Johnny spring no love child around here. This ain't personal. Now get back here. Fresh as it gets. Drink up now. See what... straight with all this craziness going on.
You ever have head cheese? It's good. Come here, I'll show you.
Now. It'll perk you right up.
Nonsense. Why is this on me to fix? What is all the others doing? Why drag her out?
Here you go, Grandpa. Here you go.
Get this sorted out, Grandpa. Don't you worry.
smack that Johnny upside his doggone head. It's all his doing.
Thank you.
Cattle mutilations continue to plague the quiet farming communities of Central Texas, as two more were reported just last evening. The cows were discovered with the throat slit and cut from belly to hip. Officials believe multiple perpetrators are responsible, as the mutilations appear to have been committed at the same time. The Sheriff's Department advises all ranchers to control their property, heavily armed, and report any suspicious activity. Local farmer Deborah Lattie told local reporters that he believes it is the work of, quote, devil worshippers. Authorities have not yet responded for comment on that claim.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.